Thank you. Easter is the queen of feasts. As Paul reminds us, if Christ has not been raised, your faith is in vain. If in Christ we have hope in this life only, we are of all people most to be pitied. Yet it is a struggle for us to keep our Easter faith for more than the Sunday or the season. We're daily bombarded by sin and its death, by temptation and its doubt, by hopelessness and its despair. This is why we follow the events of our Lord's life in the church here, which reaches its climax at the resurrection of our Lord. We are not who we were. We have been raised in Christ to new lives. Putting him first, this begins with the joyful affirmation of Christ's own victory and our appropriation of that victory to our own lives by faith. This joy compels us to share with others what we have received.
Christ is risen!
He is risen indeed! Hallelujah!
Is there a more beautiful sound in all of creation than that statement? Christ is risen, he's risen indeed, alleluia. We rejoice in the opportunity to come together and celebrate the beautiful resurrection of our Lord. A couple of announcements, our order of service will be up on the monitors. If you're with us as a guest and visitor today, we welcome you. Thank you for being here today. If you'd like to learn more about our congregation, you can follow our text in church. If you want to text 319-774-4545, it'll be up on the screens in case you didn't get that. And just put in the subject box, welcome. You'll get some more information about the church. As members, we also want to fill out, you can just put in member in that text box, same number, and get some information. Just a couple reminders, there is no service this Wednesday because you can't really replicate Easter Sunday on Wednesday evening. So we're just gonna not have a service this Wednesday. We also would love to invite everyone to stick around after church. There is a Easter brunch that the youth have been putting out. They've done a great job putting it all together. So you're welcome to stay and have brunch with us as we gather to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. Let's take a moment and share the peace of Christ with those around us.
Good morning.
the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously.
The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea.
The Lord is my strength and my song.
And he has become my salvation.
Your right hand, O Lord, glorious in power.
Your right hand, O Lord, shatters the enemy.
You have led your steadfast love, the people whom you have redeemed.
You have guided them by your strength.
You bring them in and plant them on your own mountain.
The place, O Lord, which you have made for your abode.
The sanctuary, O Lord, which your hands have established.
The Lord will reign forever and ever.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I will say to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously.
The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Today is Easter Sunday. On this day, we recall how our Lord rose from the dead to proclaim new life to all sinners captive to death and the grave. As the first visitors of the tomb heard, Christ is not here, he is risen. Today we meet our risen Lord where he promised to be, in word and sacrament, until we pass through the death of our own joyful resurrection in him. Please be seated. The first reading for this Resurrection Sunday is from the book of Acts, chapter 10. So Peter opened his mouth and said, "Truly I understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. As for the word that he sent to Israel, preaching good news of peace through Jesus Christ, he is Lord of all. You yourselves know what happened throughout all Judea, beginning from Galilee after the baptism that John proclaimed, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. He went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. And we are witnesses of all that he has done, both in country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. He put to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and made him appear, not to all the people, but to us who had been chosen by God as witnesses, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one appointed by God to be judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The epistle text is from Colossians chapter 3. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things that are above, not on things that are on the earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand in honor of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel for this, the resurrection of our Lord, is from St. Mark, the 16th chapter.
Glory to you, Lord.
When the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. And they were saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" And looking up, they saw the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed in a white robe. And they were alarmed. And he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him? But go tell the disciples and Peter that he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." And they went out and fled from the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had seized them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. We invite the children forward. Absolutely right. That's the best sermon you heard, because Jesus died. died on the cross and rose for our sins. Amen, you may go home. Because that's the whole thing, isn't it? Today, did you hear the reading? It said, very early in the morning, like way early in the morning, just as the sun was coming up. And if you look through that window, you can see the sun is just starting to come up in the sky. The women went to the grave. They thought they were going to find a dead body. Now, if you've ever seen a dead body, it's kind of strange, isn't it? They thought they were going to find a dead body. There was a big rock rolled in front of the grave. They said, who's going to move the rock? Because we're just three women and the rock is too big for us. But when they got there, what did they see? The rock had already been moved, hadn't it? So they were kind of suspicious. They went up and they slowly kind of maybe to see what they'd see. And they looked for more. What did they see inside? Yeah. Well, just this time, there's the one angel, right? They thought they would see a dead body. There's a man sitting there. You know what that man said? You look for Jesus of Nazareth as if he's dead. You're looking for a dead body, but he's not here because he has gone to Michigan. He's not here because he is what? He's not here because he is
risen.
He is risen. Jesus, who used to be dead, is now alive, and that makes this the greatest day ever. Because Jesus is alive for us. And you know what that means for us? Because he's alive, we don't ever have to be afraid of dying. Because Jesus beat death. Death had it, and Jesus punched it right in the nose, and death had to let it go. And he already said, I'm going to make sure that everyone who believes in me never has to die. Oh, your body will go to sleep, but you will go to be with him in heaven. And because he rose, each one of us are going to get to live with him in heaven forever. Now, I don't know about you, but I think that's probably a pretty good deal, what do you think? All in favor say aye? Aye. Uh-huh. You think they like the idea that we're going to go to heaven? Why don't you ask me? Good deal?
Good deal.
Good deal.
And that's why when we come to church on Easter Sunday morning, we don't just say good morning. I mean, you did, right?
Good morning, good to see you this morning.
We have a very special greeting. We only use once a year. We come in the morning and we say, Christ is risen!
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
I wasn't talking to you. Did you hear what they said? Only on Easter Sunday morning do we say, this is different than all other days. Because today we recognize that Jesus Christ is not dead, but alive. And we just want to shout it from the mountaintops. For them, please. Will you try this with me? If I say Christ is risen, you say, he is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Can you try that? Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
That was pretty good, but I don't think he was shouting it from the mountaintops. You think you can do it with a little more gusto? Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Better. I think you got one more word to do. Let me stand up. Can you guys stand up for me? And this time, when you see he's risen down, I want you to shout it like you're here. Like you're cheering on the cops. You ready? Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Let's hold our hands and pray.
Dear Jesus,
thank you
for dying for our sins.
Thank you for dying for our
sins. And rising this day.
And rising this day.
To give us life everlasting.
To give us life everlasting.
Hallelujah.